Welcome to Dear Zander Mander, the interrogation. Hi, everybody. Yes, this is an interrogation, but you're asking the questions and I'm answering them as always. Plus, I got a special guest question at the end of the show. Stay tuned. Let's go. Our first question this week is, why do ladybugs have black spots instead of red? That's easy. Black goes with everything. Hello? Our next question is, do you have a favorite book? Well, there's three that come to mind. The first favorite book that I have is a book that I've read many, many times. It is a nonfiction book. It's a biography. And it's called The Hiding Place by Corrie Ten Boom. If you want to read about something raw and real and heartbreaking, go to your local library and pick up this book. You won't regret it. Another book that I really love to read was Gracie, A Love Story by George Burns. It's a story written by George Burns, and when you read this book about his love affair with the love of his life, Gracie Allen, the book reads as if George was sitting there reading the book to you himself. It's in his own words, and you can actually hear his voice as you read it. Love this book. Great love story. Again, another nonfiction book. Now for fiction books, I love the series The Nero Wolfe Mysteries by Rex Stout. He started writing them in 1934 and he wrote over 40 of them. It's about a huge, massively obese detective and his total smartass sidekick. These are great stories, and I love the fact that they are all set back in that time period as well. It's a great read, and I guarantee you, once you read the first one, you're going to want to read the next, and you will end up going through over 40 of those books. Great books. Love them. Our next question is, can you please do a makeup tutorial video? Makeup? Sweetheart, I don't wear any makeup. I get out of bed looking like this every morning. Hello? I know you've spent a lot of time in the clubs. Do you have a favorite DJ? Wow. I have a lot of favorite DJs, but there's one who's my absolute favorite, and that's DJ Psycho Bitch. I have spent many, many hours with her. It was because of her that I had a 29-inch waist. Because I was up there dancing, sweating all night long until that place closed. She's my favorite of all time. And fortunately, I got the chance to meet her after all those years of dancing to her music. That was a highlight of my life, meeting her. Our next question is, where do you see yourself in 10 years? In a mirror, of course. Hello? It's really hot in this interrogation room. I need a drink. Okay, so it's not water, but it's still refreshing. Thank you. Our next question is, why did Mr. Stupid, S-T-O-O-P-I-D? What is this question? Where did this come from? Why did Mr. Stupid tiptoe past the medicine cabinet? Okay, these questions are getting really, really strange. But, again, why did Mr. Stupid tiptoe past the medicine cabinet? Probably because he didn't want to wake the sleeping pills. The next question is, what do you think of boobs? I love boobs. Alfred Hitchcock did not have a belly button. The great novelist Virginia Woolf stood up while she wrote all of her books. Did you know that Halle Berry's stunt double in Catwoman was a man? This may explain a lot, and I've investigated this thoroughly. George W. Bush and Hugh Hefner are cousins. Scary, isn't it? Leonardo, Leonardo, Leonardo. Dear Leonardo DiCaprio's first on-screen kiss was with a man. And not just any man, the man who played Remus Lupin in the Harry Potter films. Go, boys! No, Rosemary, I have never thought about adopting a child. And the reason I never thought about adopting a child is because I have my own son, who will be 29 this year, the same age as me. He's an old fart. Guess what time it is, everybody? It's special guest question time. This is a special interrogation. We will find out who is going to interrogate me next. Let's see who it's from, shall we? This week, our special guest question is coming from... fabulous. Rock goddess vocalist Darby Mills of the Headbanging Headpins. Yeah! Darby Mills is the lead vocalist of the supergroup Canadian band Headpins. She is known for her vocal talents. She's known as the growler, the screamer, raw and guttural. To me, she's just fabulous. Let's see what she has to ask, okay? Darby, this is a really great question, and as all of you know out there, I'm a huge music fan. So this is perfect for me. Darby, I've been noticing a trend where people are going back to more live music. I think people are starting to get sick of all the auto-tune, the lip-syncing, the fakeness. I think people are getting back to what's real. And that makes me so happy because I can't stand auto-tune. I can't stand all the lip-syncing. Unless you're a drag queen. Yay! And drag queens do the lip-syncing better anyways. But that's my answer, dears. I think it's coming around to where live music is going to be the thing again, and that pleases me more than anything in the world. I'd like to thank Darby Mills for her question. Darby, I love you. I've been a fan of yours for years. For all of you that want to find out more about Headpins and hear their music, here's all your info. I want to thank you all again for joining me this week. You do me a favor. Until next time, you have fun and you get home safe. I'll see you soon. Good night. This interrogation has now come to a close. Mind yourself.